Welcome back to our channel. Today we are discussing periodic reviews, a requirement in Arizona parenting plans. So if you're going through the divorce process in Arizona and you have minor children, you need a parenting plan. A parenting plan typically includes three main areas: parenting time, how you share time with your kids, decision making, how you make decisions regarding their care, and lastly, finances, which includes things like out-of-pocket expenses, such as extracurricular activities or health insurance costs for your kids, as well as child support and tax implications like the child tax credit. One requirement of parenting plans in Arizona is a periodic review. The idea that you should periodically review your parenting plan to make sure that it's still in the best interest of your children. You're going to make the best parenting plan that you can when you get a divorce, but as time passes and things change, items in your parenting plan may need to change as well. Most commonly, people will review their parenting plan once a year, and that's what you're dictating in your parenting plan, how often you're going to do your periodic review, so once a year, for example. Some people, particularly if they have older children, will switch it to once every 2 years. They're not concerned about as much change happening in their kids' lives. While others who have really young kids, for example, infants, might do something more frequently, like every 6 months for a period of time until the kids reach a specific age. During that periodic review, it could be something more formal, like you come back to mediation. Some of my clients once a year will come back to mediation and have conversations all together with my help. Others will do it more informally, let that be sitting down for coffee or just handling issues via email. Ultimately, I always say it's important to decide when your periodic review is going to be, including what month you're going to do it on an annual basis. The reason for this is to avoid communication issues as well as misunderstandings. So for example, if I said once a year, when is that happening? Once a year. Someone could argue, well, it's happening in January. Someone could argue it's happening in June. I always recommend to my clients that they pick a specific month, for example, January. They want to start the new year fresh every year and do a periodic review. Or maybe June. You're going into the summer and that changes up the kids' schedule and they're going into a new school year in only a couple months. That way, it avoids conflict and miscommunication. Ultimately, if something big comes up, there's a change or you need to talk about something, you can always do so outside of your periodic review. It's better to have a conversation when something happens rather than let it fester and hold on to that conflict to let it grow until you hit your periodic review. It's only going to make that conversation more difficult. So that's what a periodic review is. If you have any questions, feel free to put them in the comments below. You can always learn more at couplesolutionscenter.com. And in the meantime, I hope you have a wonderful week and I'll see you next week.